It probably won't shock you to learn that the pandemic has led to an explosion of technologies that allow us to work remotely.
And it almost certainly won't come as a surprise that the past 18 months have seen a boom in e-commerce.
But what about after the pandemic? I'm Margaux Macdonald.
And I am Davide Malacrino. And we are going to be asking, when we finally emerge from the COVID era, what will the changes to the way we live, work, and spend mean for productivity?
While forecasting long-run productivity is particularly difficult in the current environment, we combined historical data with what we know so far about how COVID-19 changed the economy to examine how productivity might change along two dimensions, digitalization and the allocation of labor and capital.
Moreover, we wanted to know how policymakers can help build on this to boost productivity and ensure that gains are broadly shared.
To answer these questions, one of the things we did was download the patent applications in the US since 2015, and then searched the data for terms like video conferencing or video meeting. This is building off work conducted during COVID by other academic economists.
And what we found confirmed what we knew to be the case anecdotally. The number of patents for e-commerce and work from home technologies has increased quite sharply since COVID.
It's one example of what economists call intangible capital. Intangible capital is a broad category that includes things like software and intellectual property, the kind of things that aren't physical but can bring value to a company, and importantly, help boost productivity.
These accelerated digitalization have been a silver lining of the pandemic. Since March 2020, even more than in other recessions, digitalization and automation have accelerated, in part following from the need to reduce physical contact.
Moreover, the pandemic has prompted a shift towards working remotely. As you can see in this chart, as much as half of some firms in some sectors in the United Kingdom have seen an increase in remote work during the crisis.
Policies must support digitalization and ensure that gains that come with it are sustained and broad-based. Also, it will be important to support adequate access to financing for viable firms seeking to invest in productivity-boosting intangible capital.
We also looked at another category, reallocation. Reallocation is the phenomenon through which some factors of production move across firms and across sectors. For example, a worker changing employer is an instance of what economists call labor reallocation. And machinery being sold from one company to another would be capital reallocation.
During the crisis, necessary emergency lifelines may have halted the reallocation process, for instance, by providing financial support to firms that would otherwise have gone insolvent.
But government support faces constraints, and once the hardship brought about by the pandemic begins to ease, it's crucial to let resources flow towards the most productive firms and those facing higher demand, including by gradually phasing out job retention schemes.
More broadly, policies need to ensure that support is well targeted, that capital in failed firms can be quickly put to more efficient use, and that displaced workers are supported so that they can move from shrinking to expanding firms and sectors.
Efficient bankruptcy procedures and well-designed employment protection laws will also be key for freeing up resources in unviable firms and facilitating reallocation towards viable, productive firms, together with measures to promote competition and curb an uncontrolled increase in market power that can harm productivity in the longer run.
But more than that, resolute efforts to reskill workers who have lost their jobs, including through on-the-job training, will help support inclusiveness, as well as help boost human capital and strengthen potential growth.
Finally, ensuring broad-based access to digital technologies and internet connectivity for both firms and workers will help ensure that gains from digitalization can be leveraged everywhere.
18 months into this pandemic, and we have reached an inflection point.
Many economies are half open, half closed, and uncertainty is still high as we wait to see which direction COVID will lead us next.
Yet, what we do know is that this is a good time for governments to reassess their policy options.